took a fairly pretty active role come 2013 when this issue was brought before us for the first time. And I would have a strong record in care and in education for sure. But this is
what
a
concrete measures did
this
you
is a big demand. This is a big response. This is a government response. That I have to be honest, I'm kind of disgusted with the way, I'm ashamed to say, my former colleague, Bunthisha Leo Bradker and Simon Harris, who were pro-life in 2011, now suddenly because they're in power and they're ministerial appointments, they're now saying this is the only way forward.
Do you think is that their motivation? Because I interviewed Taoiseach Brown.
But let me give one practical example of something I did in 2013. I opposed the criminal sanction on women for 14 years in the legislation. Leo Bradker, Simon Harris, and the government, they enforced it.
Because the Attorney General told them that was the only legal position that could be taken according
Sorry,
to the law.
It was put to us in a vote. We, the government, the houses of the Oireachtas legislative bodies, and we don't need to repeal the 8th at all. We don't need to repeal the right to life
to take away the sanction.
And that's important.
My position is totally illogical.
Yeah, it's
because I feel that, you know, with medical science, with the advances in science, with what's coming down the road, we're in a dangerous area here, guys. If we open this door without really talking it through amongst ourselves in a proper way, I don't think the Citizens' Assembly is a good idea, man. Because who are those people? I don't know them. Who do they answer to? I think Dáil Éireann is our Citizens' Assembly, and everyone in Dáil Éireann, we know how they vote, and they'll answer to us.
Sure, that's what the referendum is about. It's about giving the people of Dáil Éireann the right to bring in legislation to deal with this issue.
I just give an opinion. I think this is more liberal than most Irish people want by a long way.